Alright, another calculus question from Reddit. We want to see why is B wrong? And this question is about the definition of derivative. So we're trying to find the equivalent expression to the definition of derivative, which is just f prime of a in terms of a limit. Firstly, I would like to tell you E, the limit as h approaching 0 of f of a plus h minus f of a of h. This is definitely true. Likewise, C is also another equivalent definition. But how come B, this one, is not correct? And the main concern is that you see that the structure is very similar. We have f of a plus h minus f of a over h. And the difference is that for B, we have the limit on the top and the limit on the bottom. Compared to choice E, we only have the limit in the front. So why? All right, let's address that issue. So firstly, let's just focus on that definition, which is f prime of a being equal to the limit as h approaching 0 of f of a plus h minus f of a over h. And of course, before we learn the definition of derivative, we should also have seen the limit laws. And one of the limit laws says the following. Let me just write this down. Let's say we have the limit as x approaching some number a, a top function, let's say f of x, and the bottom function g of x. It says that, hey, let's just go ahead and do the limit as h approaching a of f of x over the limit as x approaching a of g of x. Right, that's a limit law that we have seen, and it's pretty convenient. So in this case, how come, right, this is the main concern, how come we cannot just use the limit law right here, and that should give us the limit of the top and the limit of the bottom? So why isn't this the same as the limit as h approaching 0 of f of a plus h minus f of a over limit as h approaching 0 of h? How come this is false? Oh my goodness. Well, it's not a contradiction, because you really have to pay attention to the details. In order for us to use this limit law, it's a detail. We have to make sure that, I'll tell you guys this, this is only true if the denominator here, it's not equal to 0. The limit as x approaching a of g of x, this denominator cannot be equal to 0. So, of course, if you take a look right here, just focus on this. The limit as h approaching 0 of h, this is equal to 0, right? Therefore, this is not true. And now you might be wondering, if you look back to this definition, don't we put a 0 on the bottom all the time and then just say, hey, we have a 0 on the bottom? Shouldn't that be undefined right away as well? Well, when you write this expression, in fact, you should work this inside out, meaning go ahead and work out this expression. Sometimes, and in fact, many situations, you can actually cancel the h and then take the limit as h approaching 0. So let me work out an example to make this super clear for you. Let's say I have a function. Let's just do a x squared, and let's say a is equal to 3. So if we want f prime of 3, by using that definition, it's just the limit as h approaching 0 of f of a plus 3, sorry, a plus h, and a is 3, minus f of a, which is 3, over h. And we can set this up. This is the limit as h approaching 0. F of 3 plus h, we just put 3 plus h into the x here. So we get 3 plus h squared minus f of 3, you put 3 into x, so you have 3 squared over h. So here's the deal. We are supposed to work this inside out, right? As I told you earlier, let's see. This will be the limit as h approaching 0. Expand this 3 plus h squared. You square the 3 first, you get 9. Plus 2 times 3 and h, you get 6h. Lastly, you add the h squared. And then minus 3 squared, which is 9. And then over h. On the top, you see 9 and 9 cancel. Very nice. Better yet, if you look at this and that, we can factor out an h. So this is the limit as h approaching 0 of h times 6 plus h over h. And now we can be happy because we can cancel this h. You see, we can cancel this h. Right? We always did the inside first, like this. Then we put the 0 into the remaining h. So that will give us 6 plus 0. And that will give us 6. Done. However, if earlier, right, if earlier we were doing the limit as h approaching 0 of f of 3 plus h minus f of 3 over the limit as h approaching 0 of h, well, they are not equal. Because you see that you already have to focus on what the top is and what the bottom is. And this right here gives you 0 right away. Also, you can simplify this. You will get the top like that. If you do that, you get, let me just work this out real quick. That would be 3 plus h squared minus 3 squared. And then you will end up with, you know, 9 plus 6h plus h squared minus 9, and that's just, how come going up? I don't know. Scary. And yeah, and then you take the limit as h approaching 0, like that. But by now it's too late. You are not allowed to cancel the h here and the h from the bottom because they don't belong to the same limit if you look at it like that individually. So, yes, in this case, if you're talking about computation, you get 0 right here, but you cannot proceed because of the order of operation. And so it's a different situation. They are not equal. Hopefully this right here helps, and hopefully I make this clear. So yeah, that's it.